This is the City of Rocks National Reserve in South Central Idaho. This crazy, spectacular labyrinth of rock set in this high desert setting lies at the south end of the Albion Mountains. And the City of Rocks, a lot of people get most interested in City of Rocks because of the amazing landscape features that are formed here. So this video is gonna focus on kind of the big picture and how some of these crazy shapes and forms in the rock came to be. Other videos I have on my YouTube channel will discuss the rocks themselves and kind of the geologic story behind those rocks. So as we kind of look to the north here, we can see that this landscape sits here at elevation of like about 5,000 to 7,000 feet with some higher peaks in the distance. We have Cache Peak way out there in the distance at a little over 10,000 feet. I believe this is a Graham Peak here. This is high desert country, and all this light colored rock we see here is granite. This is granite that formed about 28 million years ago. This is the youngest granite in Idaho. And granite forms when magma intrudes and rises towards the surface, but stays underground and then cools and crystallizes. So as we look at this rock up closely, we can see that it's made of more or less equally sized crystals of white material here. That's plagioclase feldspar. This gray stuff in here is quartz. And then you might catch a little glint or two in the sunlight. That's muscovite mica. And there's probably a little bit of biotite in there as well, another mica. And so this rock here forms a spectacular landscape in an area which people enjoy camping, hiking, rock climbing. That's some of their favorite recreational activities here. But mainly what we see here as we look at the City of Rocks are these sort of fins of rock that sort of run more or less north-south. And we can see a lot of fractures in the rock itself. We can also see that these fins are separated more or less, again, going in the sort of north-south direction. And so the geologic story there is as magma cools and crystallizes, it contracts and shrinks, and that creates some of the fractures in this rock. Adding to that, over the last about 17 or so million years, this area has been extended east to west. This is all part of the Basin and Range province of Western North America. So as the crust has been stretched in an east-west direction, it's created these north-south running fractures that cut through these rocks. A process that enhances these fractures getting bigger over time is frost wedging. And so here in this high desert environment, they get quite a bit of snow and rain. And in the cold months, that water freezes in those cracks. And as that ice sets up, it actually expands and widens the cracks over time. So that repeated freeze-thaw cycle is what allows these fractures to become larger and larger over time. We're gonna kind of walk down this ridge, and I'll just point out a few of the other features that we see in the granites here. There's a whole host of cool landscape features here, from arches. This is one of the more popular little small arches here. Really, it's just a little window through this ridge where there's been sufficient weathering that's cut through this rock here. This is a slightly different process than what you would see at like Arches National Park. But the granite in places has several different processes that create weathering. We even have trees. So as trees grow in fractures in the rock, the roots can expand into those fractures and widen them out. So this is a process called root wedging, which can ultimately widen out the rocks themselves. Here we have a pretty nice little face where you can see parts of the granite are just kind of falling apart. Little slabs of it are falling apart, more or less parallel to the surface itself. This is a process called exfoliation. So remember that granite forms as magma underground. So it's under tremendous amounts of pressure as it crystallizes. As it rises to the surface, once it's completely crystallized and then exposed to the surface later through uplift, once this stuff makes it to the surface and that pressure is gone, the rock actually expands outward a little bit. So because it formed under pressure, when you remove that pressure, the rock expands outward and forms these sort of concentric layers here, kind of like I guess like an onion or something like that. So this is a rock exfoliating, I guess much like your skin does, or sort of shedding off its older skin and revealing its healthy, fresh new skin underneath. And so you can kind of see some of those big sort of thin little slabs up there on that face. So let's go a little bit further. we can see maybe a few other features here. So again, City Rocks is famous for rock climbing, but some of these faces obviously don't look great for rock climbing. We'll see if we can see, here's a pretty good one here. In places, you can see that the surface is a little bit darker with this brown. This is actually kind of a weathering coating called a patina. And it's where these surfaces form that some of the better handholds and features for climbers to use sort of form as well. This face tends to be, this is the west side, and sometimes the west faces of the cliffs don't form the best patinaed surfaces. I think up here, we'll see something a little bit different. We've got, again, mostly just this granitic material here, squeezed by the trees, mountain mahoganies. And then one of the more fun, cool features we see are these cool little hollowed out caves in the rock. And you can see there's one even in here that comes around, hello, over into this area here. So these hollowed out caves that we see here, this is called cavernous wet weathering. Another word that's used to describe these is tuffoni, which is an Italian word. And the way that these are produced, we aren't too far as the crow flies from the Great Salt Lake Desert. So in the summer months or in the spring, anytime there's sort of thunderstorm activity coming in from the south, those thunderstorms can whip up with their winds salts from the Great Salt Lake that get carried up into the storm cloud. And as those storm clouds come into the southernmost part of Idaho here and that rain lets loose, some of that rain has a little bit of salt mixed in it. And as that slightly salty water gets into the rock, infiltrates the rock through cracks and other cavities, the salt, as it as it crystallizes, that salt actually expands outwards and breaks apart the rock, just sort of disintegrates it grain by grain. You can kind of see in here where I'm kind of just pawing at the rock and making it disaggregate quite a bit there. So these are some of these cool little cave features that we see in places that kind of add to the really interesting kind of myriad shapes that we see here. Here's kind of another small one there. So we'll go just a little bit further to where we get a really spectacular view, more or less to the north of this main City Rocks area. Again, with the granitic rock here. One other thing we can see from here is if you look along the ridge line out this way, you can see the lighter colored granite down here. That's that 28 million year old granite that formed not too long ago. The darker rocks along the skyline are much older. They're about 2.5 billion years old. And so what we have here is this younger granite has risen into and crystallized within this much older granitic rock that forms along the skyline. The older rock's actually harder and more resistant. That's why it forms the skyline of the high peaks. And even though this younger granite seems to be fairly resistant and it does form cliffs in places, overall it's fairly soft, and that's why it's forming a basin here. This is the Circle Creek Basin here at City of Rocks. So the fractures, the weathering processes, all part of the what's happening here to create this dynamic landscape of arches and hoodoos and fins and just an amazing landscape of crazy rocks here in this scenic high desert of south central Idaho.